Nothing beats the unique flavors of a summertime grill session. When the sun's out, there's really no other way to eat. And good lord, are there a lot of amazing chemical reactions happening over those flames. Get a bucket for your drool. We're about to get hit with some grill chem. Before your steak hits the grill, chances are it's a brilliant red. And if it's not, you better check the expiration date. But have you ever wondered what makes red meat red? Though it may seem like an obvious answer, our meats aren't getting their brilliant hue from blood. Steaks are made up of slow-twitch cow muscles, which means that they're used for long periods of time and use a lot of energy. To compensate, a protein called myoglobin helps store oxygen inside cells of muscles for a consistent energy supply. And as it turns out, this very protein is a pronounced red pigment. The more myoglobin inside the meat, the darker and the deeper the red will be. You may have noticed that vacuum-sealed steaks have a grayish tint to them. The lack of oxygen inside means a lack of fuel for myoglobin. And once you've opened the package and exposed it to oxygen, the surface of the meat will get back at least some of the reddish-pink tint. When you throw your steak on the grill, myoglobin starts to transform. At temperatures above 60 degrees Celsius, myoglobin can't hold onto the oxygen anymore, and it shifts to a tan color. Once your steak hits 76 degrees Celsius, myoglobin goes through yet another transformation where it turns a grayish dark brown. But that's not the only thing that changes your steak's color. The Maillard reaction, the holy grail of all culinary chemical reactions, is the key to the mouth-watering molecular metamorphosis that kicks in when you throw your food on the grill. The Maillard reaction is actually a complex series of simultaneous reactions between amino acids and sugars that produces that rich brown cooked food color alongside hundreds of distinct flavor compounds. Now, on the topic of flavor compounds, let's go ahead and settle this gas versus charcoal argument. While gas might be a little bit more convenient, it's kind of missing the point of grilling. Charcoal and the smoke from wood chips give off aromatic compounds that rise up and permeate through your food, giving them that real grilled flavor. For example, lignin is a compound found in wood chips. It gets broken down by heat and then produces another compound called guaiacol. This stuff has that definitively rich, smoky grill fire flavor that challenges you to push your stomach's capacity to the limits. Then on top of that, juices from your meat fall down onto the charcoal and other unique compounds rise back up and contribute to the brilliant grilled flavor. But don't overdo it with the flames, people. While you want your meats to be properly cooked on the outside, there's no need to overdo it and char them up. Not only do you lose flavor and texture by doing this, you also produce carcinogenic compounds that can otherwise be avoided by lower cooking temperatures and flipping your steaks or burgers more often. Invest in a meat thermometer, and once you hit that ideal internal temperature, kill the grill. There's always time to throw a couple dogs on the grill, so get at it. Also, check out this volume of the Chemistry Life Hack series. It's got a hack for how to cook the perfect burger. We also recently had a little collaboration with the Hybrid Librarian. Click this video link to check out 10 of the most amazing chemical reactions you'll probably ever see. Big thanks to the Hybrid Librarian for putting that together with us. Make sure to head over there to check out their channel. Have any food chemistry questions? Post them down in the comments, hit the thumbs up button, and don't forget to hit subscribe on the way out.